Beautiful day of weather across central Florida. Let me show you a picture sent in from a former WESH meteorologist. Mike Olenek was out enjoying the game, and boy, how's about that over at the Citrus Bowl? Clear skies and comfortable temperatures. Made it up to 76 degrees on the day today. Our average high temperature is 77. So we were looking just about as pretty as could be. Nowhere near that record of 92 degrees set back in the middle 1940s. Now, bigger perspective, you could see that band cloud cover kind of sitting south of us, but it is a clear sky over the Sunshine State. That cool front pushed on through. High pressure is now building in, and for us for your Sunday evening, it's a north and northeasterly kick to the old wind. Futurecast 7 o'clock looking good. Late this evening, we're going to be watching a few clouds rolling in off of the ocean. But all in all, by 5 a.m., it's a couple of clouds, but just about perfect conditions. So 63, 7 o'clock, 59 degrees for our 9 o'clock hour. And 11 o'clock, it's going to be a cloud or two overhead, 56. So you might want to have that light jacket handy. Here's a look at our neighborhood by neighborhood low temperatures. 47 in Ocala, 50 degrees in the Villages, 53 in Eustace, 52 degrees this evening in Mount Dora, 51 Paisley, 53 in Claremont, and Kissimmee has about 53 in Orlando, 51 Longwood, about 52 degrees for us in Sanford, across the lake over to Deltona, DeLand, DeBary, 53 Daytona Beach, 53 degrees New Smyrna Beach, and into the middle, even upper 50s here once we get in along the Space Coast. High pressure shifts tomorrow, and so do those winds in easterly direction. That means warmer temperatures expected, but still bright, beautiful sunshine. Mid to upper 70s are highs. Average high is 77, and we're going to be about that for the city. Beautiful. Maybe a couple of degrees warmer, frankly. 79 degrees does it in the city, 78 degrees in the Villages, middle 70s, Daytona Beach, 75 degrees in Titusville, 75 in Melbourne. Now, here's that model data coming in from Futurecast, 5 a.m. You've got those clouds sitting along the coastline. By lunchtime, though, we start to dry that atmosphere back out, get that sunshine mixing things, so only beach clouds. And then through the afternoon, it's a mainly sunny sky. That is a beautiful setup for everything except the allergy issues. On a scale of 1 to 12, 12 being just miserable for those of us allergy sufferers, look at this, 11.7 by midweek. It's going to be one of those weeks we are all going to be struggling together. If you're heading out to the area waterways, choppy on the intracoastal and the lakes and the offshore waters. Surf running 4 to 5 near shore, 4 to 6 for the boaters. So it's going to be a little bumpy out there. High tide at 6:04, 12:16, just after the lunch hour is when we hit low tide. That's when the rip currents are going to be the worst, and we happen to have a high threat for rip currents. We're going to be watching that closely. Over the next 7 days, Central Florida's most accurate 7-day forecast revealing a beautiful Monday through Friday stretch with temperatures building into the middle 80s late week. Then Saturday into Sunday, some showers returning to Central Florida.